Hello students, welcome back to the online teaching of St. Thomas School. Students, as you know that we have completed all the 6 units of our textbook. And today onwards, we are going to start the revision of all the 6 units. Today, we will see the revision of Unit 1, Exploring Symbols. In Activity 1, we have seen Rabindranath Tagore, that Rabindranath Tagore was born in Kolkata and he is a great Bengali poet. He born in the year 1861. He has written our national anthem Jana Gana Mana. He also won a Nobel Prize in Literature in the year 1913. And at the very young age, at the age of 8 years, he started writing poetry. And he published his first poem when he was only 16 years old. And for publishing his first poem, Tagore used his pen name. He did not use his real name, Rabindranath Tagore, but he used pen name. And his pen name was Bhanu Sinha. Mean in English it means sun lion. Then in activity 2 we have seen the poem which is written by Rabindranath Tagore, Where the Mind is Without Fear. In this poem the poet Rabindranath Tagore is striving for the place. He wished to go to a place, the place where the man's mind is fearless, where the man can live proudly with self-respect, where the knowledge is free, where there is no any barrier of caste, religion, language and other, where the society is free, where the society is not divided into parts, into section, where only truth prevails, when there is no place of lies, the untruth, where the people work very tirelessly to achieve perfection, where the people's mind are free, where people gets a scope for his thought, for widening his thought, for widening his action. So the place where the poet wants to reach. And finally at the end, the poet Rabindranath Tagore conveys that the place where he finds all these above mentioned things, it is nothing but a heaven of freedom. And even at he prays to God to bless his country, to awake such a kind of world. So this thing Rabindranath Tagore wanted to say through this poem, Where the Mind is Without Fear. Now let's see the new words. Match the words in column A with their meanings given in the column B. So let's see once again. Fragments means pieces broken off or detached from a complete portion. Striving means to labor hard. Dreary means cheerless. Domestic means related to family affairs. Tireless means without rest or sleep. And desert means a waterless or isolated area of land. Now let's see activity 3. Look carefully at where the mind is without fear. The poet is talking to someone. What words help you to understand who the poet is talking to? Previously, the poem which we have discussed, which is written by Rabindranath Tagore. Here, the poet is talking to whom? That we have to find out. And by which line we can understand the poet is talking to whom? So here we can understand through this poem that the poet is talking to the God, the supreme power, the God. The poet requesting God to awake his country to freedom of knowledge, freedom of thought, where only truth prevails, where there is a perfection. And by which line we can understand? Then by the last line. Into the heaven of freedom, my father, let my country awake. So this line, through this line we can understand this poet is talking to God. Our next question is that what is the subject of the fourth line? You can see in the activity 3, what's the subject of the fourth line? So here, where the words of truth come out from the depth of the heart, where the words are spoken very courageously without any fear, the words are spoken in a public, the words are spoken for the world to hear, to make them awake. That is the subject of the fourth line. And the next question is, what is lost in this line of the poem? What line is given in the poem? Where the clear stream of reason has not lost its way into the dreary desert sand of dead habit. So here the word lost is used. So what is the meaning of this lost here? So in this poem, the word lost suggests the people, those who lost their humanity, the vision of humanity by their narrow-mindedness, narrow prejudices, the narrow-mindedness of caste, creed, religion and others. So for such people, those who are believing in this narrow-mindedness, those who are lost in this narrow-mindedness, this word lost is used, suggesting them. So here, dear students, today we have discussed all these three activities in the revision. Again, you read this all three activities and whatever the questions, answers which I have given, that you prepare, new words you prepare. The further activities of this chapter we will see in the next video. Till then, take care. Bye-bye.